Well, anyone hoping that I'd break through the mold of people who saw this when they were young and are still in love with it, I'm sorry to disappoint you. I'm sorry, I see the flaws in this movie, I see where it gets too corny, and yet I still really love it. Okay, well, in case you've never seen Hook, Robin Williams is Peter Banning, a lawyer who goes with his family to London to visit the woman who adopted him, and was the inspiration for Peter Pan, Wendy Darling. When his children are mysteriously kidnapped, Wendy reveals that the story is true and Peter's children have been kidnapped by the real Captain Hook. With the help of Julia Roberts as Tinkerbell, he finds himself back in Neverland, landing in the one place he probably shouldn't be, the pirate's lair. Seriously, what the crap, Tinkerbell? He makes a deal with Captain Hook, played by Dustin Hoffman, who's hands down the best part of this movie, and he's got just 3 days to become the Pan he once was to get his kids back. Okay, let's address this right up front. When Hook was originally released in December of 1991, critics slammed it. This got harder reviews than Always, and I can definitely see why those who can't stomach Spielberg's sentimentality would dislike it. There are times here when the schmaltz goes into overload and comes off really clunky. But there's just so much about this movie that I really like, and not in the way that I just liked when I was a kid, but there's a lot of stuff I appreciate as an adult. I love the production design, I love the sets. Yes, they're obviously sets, but this is Neverland, it's magical, it's heightened reality. If they made this today, it would be all CGI, and in my opinion, feel even more fake. Though I do think the strongest stuff in the movie is in the first half hour or so, before you actually get to Neverland. There's some great dramatic buildup and has this wonderful dark atmosphere about it. And it's only highlighted by John Williams' beautiful score. I know this one doesn't get mentioned a lot, but I think this is one of his best scores ever. I also just love the premise of this movie, and while the plot isn't airtight, I'm not sure why Peter has never been curious why he has no memory of his childhood, the concept is explored really well, and there are far more moments that work than don't. I love the cast too, well, most of the cast. Julia Roberts is really the weakest link here, and it kind of feels like she was cast just because she was a popular actress at the time. She comes off a bit too cutesy, but it's 90s Julia Roberts, that was kind of her shtick. But Bob Hoskins, Dustin Hoffman, the kid who played Rufio, Maggie Smith, and Robin Williams, which, looking back, must have seemed like a bizarre casting choice. But like a lot of his performances, some of his best moments are his quiet, dramatic moments. I get that what a lot of people just don't like about this movie is the tone, the over-sentimentality. But where I thought it really failed with a simple romance in Always, it worked so much better here. Maybe because it's a fantasy, or maybe because it's aimed more towards kids. And if it doesn't work for you, I get it. But it seems to have worked for a lot of people, especially those who saw it when they were young. And even as an adult, this is a movie that still hooks me in. Yes, I just did make that pun. I am sorry. If you need me, I'll be over here in the corner quoting this movie.
Mother lover.
Nearsighted gynecologist.
Magic!